Hello everyone and welcome back to Genie Crafts. In my last Q&A video, one of the questions that was asked was that how do we decide what part to cut and what part to keep in a portrait? So today in this particular portrait paper cutting video, I'm going to discuss tips and tricks related to portrait paper cutting and also answer the questions that were raised in my last video. To discuss the various aspects of the portrait paper cutting, I have chosen Mohanlal, a great Indian actor, as the subject of this video. So here is a close-up printout of the stencil that I have already created for this particular image that I downloaded from internet. Now, one of the most burning question and also most frequently asked question is that how do you decide what part to cut and what part not to cut? It depends upon two major factors. First is on what color paper you have taken the printout. Normally people take printout of the portrait stencil on a white paper and they place the cutout against a black background. So this entire video is keeping this assumption into mind. Now assuming that you have taken printout on a white paper, the thumb rule of portrait paper cutting is that if there is any exposed skin, you do not cut it out. So normally when you look at a person, there are certain features in any person which are by default dark. For example, the hair, the eyebrows, the eyelashes, the shadow under the folds of the ear, near the nostrils, you know, in case it's a image of a man, then the facial hair, the beard, the mustache, also the, you know, the shadow under the folds of the collars, clothing, etc. So these are the areas that you cut. But by default, the cheeks, the forehead, etc. are, you know, outside of the shadow. That means that you do not cut it. Similarly, when it comes to eyes, you will see that the white of the eye is something that you never cut out. This is one of the most common mistake that I have seen people doing, is that when they cut out the eyes in a portrait, they keep the pupil of the eye, but they remove the white of the eye. So what happens is that when you place it against a black background, it looks like ghosted eyes, which is not good. So take a look, or you know, think about how a normal person looks, and whatever you feel is, you know, dark in the, you know, features of the person, you cut it out so that when you place it against a black background, it becomes normal. So that's how you actually decide what to cut and what not to cut. Also, the second most important part is that if you have decided, let's say on the face, that you are going to remove the black portions, then rest of the white portion needs to be interconnected. The best portrait paper cuts are those in which once you are done with the paper cutting, the entire cutout is one single connected piece of paper. If there are multiple pieces of paper that you need to arrange, that's not really good portrait paper cutting. That you are basically doing a arrangement of different paper cutouts. But if you are serious about a portrait paper cutting, then the entire portrait paper cut needs to be interconnected. So for that, if you have decided that you have to keep the white, ensure that all the areas are interconnected. Normally, whenever you will create a stencil, you will see that there are certain enclosed areas because of the way the stencil is created. You can never create a perfect stencil. So like you just saw on the screen that I was trying to interconnect the white areas with the help of a white gel pen. So this will ensure that when I'm doing the paper cutting, I do not accidentally cut off large white areas. Now there will be certain small white areas for which you won't be able to do anything. So that's okay, you can leave them, but try to interconnect as much as you can. But in the process of interconnecting, do not just destroy the layout of the stencil. It should not drastically alter the layout of the stencil. Minor changes here and there are not noticeable, but any major change will become noticeable in the final cutout. Also, if there are outlines missing somewhere, then you can use a pencil, you know, to create the outline so that you are always mindful of the boundaries under which you need to cut. So these are the things that you need to take care of or keep in mind before you actually start the paper cutting. You should prep your stencil properly before you start the paper cutting. Trust me, no matter which software you use, free tool, paid tool, online utility, it doesn't matter. No utility can create a perfect stencil. There is certain amount of manual work that you will need to do on top of your stencil so that you can get the perfect portrait paper cutout. Once you are done with the prep of the stencil, start your portrait paper cutting with a blade of your preference. You can use any blade that you want, because normally we cut portraits on up to 100-150 GSM paper and don't go beyond that. Now, when it comes to clothing, there is no such rule as to what to cut and what to keep. The stencil for the clothing will appear depending upon the color of the clothing in the actual picture. if the color of the clothing was dark in the actual picture, then most of the areas in the clothing will come as dark. If you are not able to successfully, you know, cut out dark and keep the white, then you can reverse it and, you know, you can remove the white and cut out the dark. In my case, the person was wearing a white shirt, so majority of the stencil that you see as part of the clothing is white and just the shadow areas have come as dark, so it's pretty easy for me to cut out. But once again, on clothing it really doesn't matter. The max that will happen is that you will get the inverse of the actual clothing color, but since anyway you are doing the portrait paper cut on black and white, so it doesn't make that much of a difference. So complete the portrait paper cut on the clothing area or rest of the portrait except the face, and once you are done with the rest of the areas, then we can proceed with the face part. Once you are done with the rest of the portrait, now it's time to focus on the face. If it's a man's portrait you are making, then in that case, first work on the beard and the mustache and the lips. And if it's a female portrait you are making, then you can start with the lips, then the nose area, then the eyebrows, the hair, and finally the eye. I normally always keep eye for the last, because if rest of the portrait is done, I have very high motivation to ensure that I do not mess up the eye. Because the moment I mess up the eye, I really need to just restart the portrait, because you cannot do corrections in the eye area, because there is very small details in the eye area and it's very easy to mess up there. So I keep it at last and I do it very patiently and very slowly so that I do not make any mistakes in the eye area. And lastly, we come to the hair. Normally I cut hair before the eye, but I was just going in a sequence. I forgot that I had hair left to do. So in hair, follow what stencil has given you. But if you feel that, you know, you need to create additional cuts, additional design on the hair, then that's completely your call. You can, you know, always make additional cuts and additional design. Just ensure that when you are near the border of the hairline, try to leave some gap, because when you do the cutout, the final cutout, removing the portrait from rest of the paper, at that time it is required to have a certain buffer border so that you do not break your portrait. So it's necessary to have certain buffer border, so try avoid cutting too close to the borderline of the hair. Once you are done with your portrait paper cutting on all the areas of your portrait, then it's time to cut along the border. Just ensure that while you are cutting the border, you are not actually breaking your portrait anywhere. So be very careful about that, because portrait paper cutting is a long process and at times we forget where the previous cuts were. So do it carefully and cut along the border of your portrait so that you can remove the actual portrait paper cut from the rest of the paper. And here is my portrait after I put it against a black background. It has come out exactly as I wanted. Obviously, it will not exactly mimic the real picture, but it is like almost 95-98% mimicking the actual picture from which I have created the stencil. I hope you guys found this video useful. If you guys liked it, then please do not forget to hit the like button and share this video with your friends. Also, do subscribe to my channel for regular videos on paper arts, and I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Till then, stay safe, take care, and bye bye.